There is a consistency in development amongst F1 team for 2021 since the floor cutout regulation is now in effect. All the teams have forcefully narrowed their side pods, so much so that the center pod has taken the brunt of it. The air scoop body, coke bottle area is significantly larger now. The engine bay outlet is larger too, maybe so they could run smaller side pods, scavenging more air through the smaller side pod intake. There were talks that the longer wheelbase setup will be affected most by this new rule. The reason is that the regulations stipulate that the cutout to start at 1,800 mm behind front wheel. We will use Jojo Piola's illustration here, as it is always the best available. So if you have a short car, the distance between the cutout starting point to the rear wheels is less, which also means less surface area removed. If you have a long wheelbase car, that 1,800 mm is not going anywhere, nor is there any ratio change. The cutout will begin at the 1,800 mm mark and then move towards where the rear wheel cutout is. For instance, if there is a cutout regulations that says the cutout is ratio based off the wheelbase, then the longer chassis cars would have the cutout further back. Questions can be raised that how come the regulators did not choose this option. This gives some basis to the Mercedes-AMG Aston Martin Formula 1 camp, that the cutout is aimed at affecting the longer wheelbase cars more. At the moment, modifications to other areas are made, while teams are still maintaining their usual setup on the rake and wheelbase. The floor cutout regulations has exposed how effective the previous floor was on the diffuser. Now the rear diffuser has even more of a droop to it at the corners, or at its shoulder, affected by the cutout, and also a more shallow throat opening. Before, it was really aggressive. So how busy is the rear section of the floor's top surface, getting so much attention for 2021? Let's turn on full speculation mode. Sergio Perez's Ferrari Racing Point would make a model choice for this example. The irony of today's secretive, intricate development of aerodynamics leading mishaps to play star witness. Let's break down this footage, which sees the trailing smoke coming out of Perez's Racing Point. Here we see the side pod directing air towards the outer corner floor, where now the cutout of the floor is mandatory by the new regulations. What's very interesting here is how aerodynamicists have already prepared the intensity of that vortex way before its intended area of use. It's there to seal the floor while influencing the rear wheel wake away from the diffuser, probably even to boost the diffuser, yeah? That intensity really goes to show the significance of this vortex. Again, here we can see the advantages of having a longer floor on the long wheelbase cars, and that is more surface area and more vortex area. With the cutout floor, it looks like one of the reasons they would reduce the width of the side pod is to maintain 2020 aerodynamic proportions relative to a narrower floor. That vortex now would have to move more inwards. So maybe we can expect many more vertical aero elements on the side of the floor to replace the removal of the floor edge gratings. Further down, the rear section also confirms that there is a vortex that tucks within the coke bottle shape coming from the top of the side pod. After the floor cutout, teams have pushed for even more depth on this area, probably trying to find even more space in relation to the cutout. Wonder how important that vortex is, and maybe it is there to drag more air downwards towards the diffuser before the suspension components get in the way. In this picture posted on the page, another suspicion is that the back of the side pods and coke bottle area is designed to take advantage of the outflow of air off the side pods, leading to negative pressure behind. Feeling this pressure creates another vortex spinning inwards to gain traction on air and force more air downwards towards the floor for top diffuser performance, and this seems to be the case on the video, unless they are using this vortex to get a direct effect on the diffuser itself. Another interesting is how that smoke coming off the top of the side pod is attached to the steeply declining surface. It does give us ideas of how it can be made more intense, creating a vortex far forward of the coke bottle area, that would end up influencing that vortex next to the gearbox. It also gives a good case for running along a chassis car because it could gain more advantage here, getting longer vortex time and space towards the diffuser. Just look at the side form of the W11, W12 Mercedes-AMG. How the side pod is pushed as far forward as possible even though they are running the longer chassis. As much as the longer floor being touted for having more surface area for ground effect, here is another area where they could gain an advantage. The raft of changes just based on the simple floor cutout is very impressive. Literally a cut and paste job for a narrow aerodynamic path to fit a narrow floor, but what is also clear is it also exposes how bespoke some teams are compared to the teams with limitations. Compare the McLaren side pods to the Williams and it reveals this.
You fucking bastard.